Anxiety in the Brain, How to Help It. I'm Dr. Trish Leigh. If you struggle with anxiety, I want you to know that at the core is brain dysregulation. We know from scientific studies that when you have feelings of anxiousness on the inside, primarily worry, hypervigilance, meaning you're always on red alert, rumination, meaning you're always thinking, or you may have a lot of negative thoughts and you cannot stop them, that ticker tape of thoughts in your mind cannot be reduced. You may have physical symptoms of nausea, muscle tension, you might feel sick, you may have panic attacks. We know when you have these feelings of anxiety, it's because there's an external stressor that has evoked this anxiety response in your nervous system because whatever is happening is not being able to be processed in real time. So what happens is your brain gets stuck in a neuro-rigid pattern using much too much extra fast high beta, it's called, extra fast energy in your brain. It's very fast electrical energy. So for you to feel calm and focused, we want your brain to be resonating at the perfect calm focus speed of 8 to 12 hertz. 8 to 12 cycles per second. But when you feel anxious, your brain is going 21 to 30, maybe even faster. 21 to 30 hertz is very fast energy in the brain. I'm able to see that using an imaging technique that's called QEEG brain mapping. It uses electroencephalogram, so it measures the electrical energy and then it creates a visualization in the form of a colored map. And when anxiety is at play, what happens is the high beta, very fast brain map has a lot of red in it, meaning that high beta is used excessively, a lot of extra fast, high fast energy. At the same time on that brain map, we usually see low alpha. Alpha is that medium speed of 8 to 10 hertz. So your brain's using 30 hertz, it cannot get to 10 hertz. It can't get to the speed where you feel calm and focused. This is the problem. Essentially, the brain is ramped up and it stays ramped up and it's not shifting down into those slower speeds to get a break, to restore, to get recovery. It's very important that your brain comes out of high beta and gets into alpha, because if not, burnout is what's coming next. And when you experience burnout, you will have lowered power in your brain. It will impact everything you do and how you feel. So to be able to stop anxiety in its tracks, it's essential to lower high beta. There's new scientific studies that show this, that in order to lower high beta, you can use neuromodulation techniques like neurofeedback. I'm a neurofeedback provider. I'm a certified provider. I didn't become one and then start touting the efficacy of neurofeedback. What happened was, back when I was a college professor, I was investigating all the neurotherapies that are out there. Essentially, I bought one of everything and I was doing studies. But then eventually I was led to EEG and then to neurofeedback because it's highly effective and it's non-invasive. So what that means is, it doesn't put anything into you. It uses operant conditioning to teach your brain to make more of that medium speed and less of that fast speed. And if you just think about it logically, the way that it works is, and this is how all learning works, operant conditioning is a learning theory, and basically it's based on Hebb's law, or it goes hand in hand with Hebb's law. Neurons that fire together wire together. So what happens is, when you are engaging in neurofeedback, your brain is reinforced, it's rewarded for using more of that alpha calm speed. If it goes out of alpha and it moves towards using more high beta, you don't receive punishment. What happens is there's lack of a reward. There's non-reinforcement. So the way that it works with the neurofeedback system that I use is that when your brain's making more alpha, you're watching a video. It can be on any streaming service. It's through a highly advanced professional app. So you're watching a video that you want to see and you want to hear. When your brain's making alpha, the screen plays bright, the audio plays loud. If your brain goes out of alpha and starts making more high beta, what happens is the screen goes dim and the audio goes low. And inherently, your brain will work to hear and see the video. Einstein characterized the brain as the most complex thing in the universe. Using neuroplasticity, your brain's able to change itself. There's lots of books about that. So when you push it in the direction towards positive reinforcement for a positive brain performance pattern, and you keep reinforcing it with neurofeedback, it hardwires itself in. That's my job. I help people do that. That's why I'm here, because I want you to know if you're suffering from anxiety, you don't have to. Most definitely, your brain is stuck using too much high beta, and we can shift it into a mode where it uses less high beta, more alpha, so you can feel calm and focused. You can leave the worry, the rumination, the hypervigilance, the nausea, the muscle tension, leave it all behind so you can feel and perform better. If you want more information, please go over to drtrishleigh.com. I'd love to help. And until next time, control your brain or it'll control you.